Now I want to start with one sum on share capital transactions. Observe the sum on the screen. First, I will read the sum for you. Akash Limited issued 80,000 equity shares of Rs. 10 each at 10% discount. 10 rupees into 10%, so 1 rupee is the discount. To raise the additional capital. Now, shares can be issued at discount to raise the additional capital. When the company is incorporated, and when company is going for the first time issue of shares to the public, shares cannot be issued at discount. But after the company is working as a going concern, and if company wants to raise additional capital, shares can be issued at discount. This is what you know when theory was discussed. The issue was fully subscribed, so company wanted to issue 80,000 shares. Issue is fully subscribed, so applications are received to the extent of 80,000 shares. Amount called up was as under: 3 per share on application, 2 per share on allotment, 4 per share on final call, 2 plus 3 plus 4, 9, 1 rupee is the discount, 9 plus 1, 10, that makes the face value. Discount is to be considered at the time of allotment, so accounting for discount will be done when allotment money gets due. Company forfeited 400 shares held by Dharti for non-payment of money due on allotment and final call, and forfeited 600 shares held by Gagan for non-payment of final call. Except this, all sums due were received. So how many shares are forfeited? 400 shares of Dharti and 600 shares of Gagan. 1000 shares are forfeited. Out of forfeited 600 shares, including 300 shares of Dharti were reissued. So out of 1000 shares, 600 shares are reissued. So all the shares are not reissued. The forfeiture is in two lots. One lot of 400 shares, that of Dharti. 600 shares of Gagan, they are forfeited. So two lots are there that has been forfeited. Now out of first lot, 400 shares, 300 shares are reissued. Out of second lot of 600 shares, that has been forfeited, 300 shares are reissued. So out of total shares forfeited, part of the shares are reissued. And in such situation, the student should be very careful when he decides the amount to be transferred to capital reserve, that is surplus of share forfeiture income over reissue discount granted. The shares have been reissued at a price of 6 rupees per share. So reissue price is 6 rupees. 1 is the normal discount. 6 plus 1, 7. Share of 10 each. So reissue discount granted is 3 rupees. So after this 3 rupees reissue discount deducted out of forfeiture income, whatever the amount stands, that gets transferred to capital reserve. Now observe. Here, Dharti has not paid. Here, Dharti has not paid allotment and final call. So Dharti has paid only application. Dharti has paid only application. And application money is 3 rupees per share. And the reissue discount granted is also 3 rupees per share. So entire forfeiture income is granted as reissue discount in case of 300 shares of Dharti. So no amount left to be transferred to capital reserve in case of Dharti. Now look at the case of Gagan. 600 shares. He has not paid final call. So he has paid application and allotment. So 3 plus 2, 5 rupees per share is being paid. Out of that, 3 rupees is the reissue discount. So 2 is the surplus. Now 2 surplus will be transferred to capital reserve on how many shares? The shares that has been reissued. How many shares of Gagan were reissued? 300 shares. Because total reissued shares are 600 and out of them 300 are of Dharti. So 300 shares of Gagan are reissued. So on 300 at rupees 2 per share, that is the surplus of share forfeiture income over the reissue discount granted. So 300 into 2, 600 will be transferred to capital reserve. See, this is an initial explanation while explaining the sum. The same will be once again taken care of and considered while solving the sum. Now let me start with Barking. Important point that you are also required to prepare share discount account and share full feature account after writing all the journal entries. Now let me start Barking. ₹80,000 shares are issued. The issue is fully subscribed. So we have received application to the extent of 80,000 shares. Compare these two. There is no refund and rejection of shares, share applications. So refund is nil. How the amount is demanded? 3 with application, 2 plus 1 discount at the time of allotment, and final call 4 rupees per share. This is how the amount is decided to be collected on the shares that has been issued. Now 80,000 into 3, amount received with application, amount refund is 0. So this is the amount that is transferred to equity share capital account. Amount due on allotment at the rate of rupees 2 per share, 1,60,000. This is the amount to be amount to be collected at the time of allotment of shares. The discount allowed at the instance of allotment, 80,000 into 1, discount allowed 80,000. What is the capital gets due in the final call? 80,000 into 4, this is the capital get that is due when the final call is demanded. Now, on how many shares we have not received and how? What is the total amount received? Let us work out. Now, one of the shareholders, Dharti, on 400 shares, has not paid allotment money and has also not paid the final call. So this is the amount not received against allotment and against final call. The another shareholder, Gagan, allotted 600 shares, has not paid this final call. So 600 into 4, this is the amount not received. All other amounts are received. So let me work out. The amount received at the instance of allotment, 1,60,000 minus 800, and here 20,000 minus 4,000, this is the amount that has been received on final call. Now I want to write on the journal entry. Let me start the application. Bank account debit, equity share application account credit at the rate of rupees 3 per share on 80,000 applications that has been received. So bank account debit, equity share application account credit. Now this application money totally transferred to equity share capital account. So the journal entry for that is equity share application account debit, equity share capital account credit. Observe it on the screen. This is how two entries recorded for accounting for application. Now what is the allotment due? On 80,000 shares at the rate of rupees 2 per share, 1,60,000. Discount allowed at the time of allotment of shares at the rate of rupees 1 per share on 80,000 share. Share discount is a loss, capital loss. Expenses and losses are debited. So equity share discount account is debited 80,000 into 1. Share discount account debit to share capital account credit to 40,000. Now, how much amount have I received with allotment? 1,59,200 bank account debit to equity share allotment account credit, 1,59,200. Observe by these two entries, there stands a debit balance in share allotment account to the extent of amount not received 800. Now, this is a recoverable amount, receivable amount, but yet not received. So, what happens with this amount? Either it is received in future. When it is received, then allotment account is to be credited. And if it is not received, the shares are forfeited and the same amount now become never recoverable. Then also the allotment account is to be credited. So if this amount is recovered in future, then we have to write the entry bank account debit to allotment account 800. If the amount is not received, then the shares are forfeited. And when the shares are forfeited, the amount is never recoverable. When it is never recoverable, then also you have to credit share allotment account 800, because there stands a debit balance of 800 after these two entries. Now let me proceed with final call. Equity share final call account debit 8,000 into 4 to equity share capital account. amount receivable is 3,16,000. So bank account debit to equity share final call account credit. Now if you observe, there's a debit balance in share final call account 4,000, that is known as calls in arrears. Either this calls in arrears are recovered in future. When it is recovered, what's the entry? Bank account debit to equity share final call account credit 4,000. But if this, such amount is not recovered, then what is the course of action that company can follow? Company can forfeit the shares. When the shares are forfeited, what happens? This amount that was recoverable is now never recoverable. So share first call account gets credited in the forfeiture entry also by 4,000. So this debit balance in share final call account gets squared. Now I want to make a working for forfeiture. Let me find out the capital received on shares of shares allotted to Dardi. This is the capital received. Now when these shares are forfeited, remember the discount that was allowed to all the shareholders at rupees 1 per share on forfeiture, the same discount gets disallowed. And when the discount gets disallowed, in forfeiture entry, share discount account is to be credited. Now what's the capital received in case of Gagan? 1800 capital received. 600 into 2, this is also the capital received. And what is the discount that gets disallowed on forfeiture of shares held by Gagan? So this is the discount that gets disallowed. Now when I want to write a forfeiture entry, called up capital is cancelled, so equity share capital account is to be debited. The discount that gets disallowed is to be credited to equity share discount account. The capital received is to be credited to equity share forfeiture account. The allotment not received is to be credited to share allotment account credit 800, and the final call not received 4,000 is to be credited to equity share final call account. Now let me write out. This is a called up capital. So equity share capital account debit 10,000, 1,000 into 10 called up capital. Share discount account is to be credited to the discount that gets disallowed 1,000. On 1,000 share at the rate of rupees 1 per share, 1,000 share discount account credit. When discount is allowed, share discount account debit. When the share discount is disallowed, discount account is to be credited. And the same discount when allowed at the time of reissue, once again discount account gets debited. This is the journey of share discount account. Now capital received. This is the total capital that has been received credited to share forfeiture account. Allotment dues not received 800 credited to share allotment account, and final call not received is credited to share final call account. This is how forfeiture entry gets recorded. Now all the shares are reissued to be 6 per share. All shares? No. Out of 1000 only 600 shares are reissued. That's an important point to be noticed by you. So 600 into 6 bank account debit. Now at the time of reissue of shares, the discount that was disallowed gets once again allowed, so share discount account is to be debited. Equity share discount account debit on 600 shares at rupees 1 per share, 600 share discount account debit. Now the capital, the cancelled capital 10, amount received 6, discount allowed 1, 6 plus 1, 7. So what is the reissue discount? Reissue discount is at the rate of rupees 3 per share. Now this reissue discount is to be given out of this forfeiture income. So when the reissue discount, special discount, additional discount over and above the normal discount that has been granted is to be debited to share forfeiture account. So share forfeiture account debit 600 into 3, 1800. 2. Equity share capital account credit 600 into 10, 6,000. This is how reissue entry gets recorded. Now I want to find out the amount to be transferred to capital reserve. That I have tried to explain you in a summarized way while reading the sum. But here I am going to prepare an elaborate note for that for your better understanding. Look at it. shares forfeited, that of the 400, that of the 600. The forfeiture income is 1200 in case of 30, and it is 3000 in case of Gagan. What is the share forfeiture income per share? 1200 divided by 4, 3 rupees. 3000 divided by 6, 5 rupees. How many shares are reissued? 300 of 30 and 300 of Gagan. So total forfeiture income on shares reissued, 300 into 3 and 300 into 5. That is the forfeiture income for those shares which have been reissued. So total forfeiture income 900 and 1500. How much reissue discount is granted? 300 into 3 reissue discount. How much reissue discount granted to Gagan? 300 into 3, 900. So 900 minus 900, no balance left to be transferred to capital reserve in case of shares reissued, that of 30, and here 600, that is to be transferred to capital reserve. So nil plus 600, that amount gets transferred to capital reserve. What's the entry for that? Share forfeiture account debit to capital reserve account credit. So if we share forfeiture account debit 600 to capital reserve account credit, 600. I'm sorry, it should be capital reserve account. This is how you can write all the 9 entries. What is the total of 9 entries? Observe it. The total of 9 entries I just write down here before you. Now I want to demonstrate all the 9 entries with narration for your better understanding, and I'm going to prepare 2 accounts that has been questioned to me in the sum. Observe it. These are all 9 entries which I already explained to you. Now I want to prepare 2 relevant accounts that has been questioned. Ask me in the question itself. Observe it. Share discount account. I have already explained you the journey of share discount account. When share discount is allowed at the time of allotment, share discount account is debited. When the same discount gets disallowed on forfeited shares, share discount account is to be credited. Out of the forfeited shares, whatever the shares are reissued, once again normal discount is allowed. At that time, once again the share discount account is to be debited. And the balance of share discount account gets worked out. Observe it. Discount allowed on allotment 80,000. Share discount account debit equity share capital account. Third number is journal entry. So three number is recorded here. Now discount gets disallowed. So discount account is credited is 1,000. Now same discount once again allowed at the time of reissue 600. Share discount account debit. Now you can find out the balance of share discount account. This is the balance carried forward for share discount account, 79,600. How many shares are not reissued? Out of 1000 shares, 600 shares are reissued. 400 shares are not reissued. So what is the discount on 400 shares? 400 rupees. What is the balance of share discount account? Total discount 80,000 minus 400, 79,600. Is the balance of share discount account. Now I want to prepare the another account, that is share forfeiture account. Forfeiture account is credited on capital that is forfeited at the time of forfeiture. Out of forfeiture income, the discount, reissue discount is granted at the time of reissue of shares. Observe it. Share forfeiture income is 4,200. Reissue discount granted 1,800, debited to share forfeiture account. This is amount transferred to capital reserve. So forfeiture account debit to capital reserve account credit 600. Now you can work out the balance of share forfeiture account. That works out to be 1,800. 1800 is the balance of share forfeiture account. That balance is a forfeiture income of the shares, though forfeited but not reissued. 1000 shares are forfeited, 600 shares are issued, reissued. 400 shares are not reissued. So whatever the forfeiture income is there on 400 shares, that stands as a balance in share forfeiture account. This is an important understanding that you should hold. Now I have written all the journal entries with narration, prepared necessary accounts. I have tried to explain this sum with some repetitions also for a better understanding. Now observe the two accounts that I have prepared. I just show you these two accounts on another slide for better evaluation. I think you have followed this sum. Thanks to all of you.